Thank you. So, since yesterday we are here at the PyCon, I am looking a little bit over your shoulders on your laptops. I have seen that you have learned nothing. Who is already using this keyboard layout, the standard US keyboard layout? Okay, more, but not everyone. Okay, so I will show you that with this keyboard layout, you can actually program in Python, and you can type in a few languages, such as English, and a few more, maybe. Ale ako náhle chcete napísať moje priezvisko, ktoré je šedivé, o ktorom budem zajtra rozprávať na mojej prednáške, tak potrebujete slovenskú klavesnicu, ktorá nie je kverty, ale kverc. Hore čísla sa robia so shiftom, napravo sa niečo mení, no ale potom môžete napísať všetky tieto čiarky, teda mekčenie, dlžne, dvojbodky, vokanie a tak ďalej. Wenn man jetzt aber auf Deutsch schreiben will, also die Umleute und schaffe es, dann braucht man wiederum die deutsche Tastatur und da, die ist wiederum ein bisschen anders, also kverc genauso wie die slowakische, aber rechts und oben ändert sich wieder irgendwas. Ist nicht so einfach zum Programmieren. Und wenn man das große Schaffe ist, was jetzt gerade, also seit 3 Jahren in der deutschen Orthographie erlaubt ist, schreiben will, dann kriegt man das nicht hin, weil Shift Schaffe es ein Fragezeichen zurückgibt. Česká klavesnice sa veľmi podobá slovenskej klavesnici, ak chcete nejaké THčky, čárky, U s kroužkem, ale zase nejaké sú tam rozdiely, a když chcete programovať Pythonu, napríklad, tak to není úplne ono. Est-ce que quelqu'un a déjà écrit sur un clavier français? C'est ni QWERTY, c'est ni QWERTY, c'est AZERTY. Le M, il est ailleurs. Le point, on le fait avec un shift. Alors, écrire sur Vim, c'est pas vraiment pratique. Et tout est un peu différent, mais si on a besoin de CDI, accent circonflexe, etc., alors on en a vraiment besoin. Tecla de castellano es un poco más diferente, con los puntos abiertos de exclamación en interrogación. Et la N, on necesitáis para programar, no es tan fácil. Klaviatúra polská je bardzo podobná do klaviatúry amerikanskej, ale ak chcete písať jakéž tie kropky, ogonky, kresky i do kogož došie na živak, žekož, bženčiši, kieviži, mieška, šončiša, vošice, poviat, venkovody, je spotreba klaviatúry polskej. Testiera italiana, no ne prifáčile di scrivere perché le lettere accentuate minuscule ci sono sempre due per natas, no ne possibile di scrivere le lettere majúscule. Po svensko anwendermo omet ring o magyar ABC-ben kettes eles ékezet elalható is, ve kvankam esperanto estas internacia lingua ankaŭ li ekzistas kelkaj tre specialaj literoj, ve türkše de bujognok tali ive, kücsüknok tasis ivar. And we'll only scratch the surface. So imagine that every day you need to type in a few European languages, and how can you actually remember all these different keyboard layouts and to switch between them, because they all these letters, they just, or characters, the special characters that you need to program, they just walk around the keyboard, and this is complete chaos. You can use character maps if you use, you need some special characters from time to time, but this is not something that you can use for frequent typing in different languages. But fortunately, in the 80s, there was a compose key on the keyboards, which could be used to type sequentially, because if you can't play piano or type in Emacs, you can just type one key at a time. So with a compose key and 2 other keys, you can get actually any character that you need. So with compose and 2 other keys, which is very easy to remember, you can type these letters in most European languages and even a few ASCII emojis, or not ASCII, but text emojis. It is quite difficult, quite easy to remember, to learn, because it is already in your program, in your on your computer. This is this file. If you use a standard operating system, you just have a look into this file. In this file, there are over 6,000 lines with different characters and combinations, and it is really logical to learn it. If you don't find everything that you need, you can even define your own characters if you type some special characters more frequently. It is in your home directory in the Xcompose. So we know how to use it, on your keyboard layout, there is probably no compose key, but we have some of it, and there are a few keys that you probably don't use every day, like the menu right window key or the print screen key, and you can define it this way. All you have to do is to say set XKB map US or the other keyboard layout that you are using, and then to tell my compose key is, for example, menu key. Okay, but I'm already standing here. We are going to hack our keyboard a little bit more. Which key are we going to touch? Yes. Who needs caps lock anyway, no? For example, let's do a control out of it. So I say my compose key is in menu, and my caps lock is actually a control modifier. But that's not everything. We can do even more. We can use our caps lock as 2 keys at the same time, control and escape. Because control, you usually press it, hold it, and press something else. Escape, you just hit it. So actually your caps lock can react to two movements differently, and then everything you have to do is install Xcape program, start it, and then your caps lock can be used as a caps control and escape at the same time. So we are done. Put stickers a little bit smaller than that, and now you can really type your names if you are somewhere from Europe in all the languages that are there. And if you want to hear more about all these special characters and how the names are written with them, see you tomorrow at my talk, Your Name is Invalid. Thank you very much.